want to talk more about moving cattle off wheat with Dave Wallman, our beef cattle extension specialist. And Dave, this is something producers shouldn't really do on a whim, moving those cows.
They're going to have to plan ahead because, you know, you need to be persistent about monitoring those pastures. And that's just going to take some planning and time.
And if I'm relocating my cattle, what specifically should I keep in mind?
Well, once you've made the decision to remove them from pasture, most of these cattle are going to go into a market channel right at that time, and they'll move on into a feed yard or some growing program somewhere else. But some of the cattle perhaps will come off of the wheat pasture and go back to a dry pasture at home or a dry lot at home. And I think the main thing there is that they don't want to go backwards, because those cattle are going to come off of wheat having gained 2 to 3 pounds a day. And, you know, if they've been out there for a long time, they may be a little bit on the fleshy side. So the last thing you want to do is to let those cattle lose some of that flesh and weight that you've worked hard and spent all those resources to gain. So they do need, if they come off wheat, they probably do need to go to a dry roughage of some type to kind of get them dried up. But you don't want to stay there very long. They need to be built up an energy type diet, more concentrate to get them growing again before they do go on into a market channel.
And overall in Oklahoma, how has it been this season in terms of weight gain and other issues?
Well, we don't have very many case studies yet to show how gain has been, but it should be really good. You know, it's been a fairly dry, it's been cold at times, but it's been fairly dry. And usually when we have relatively dry conditions, cattle do well on wheat. I'd say the biggest problem is that it's just ending too soon for some people who haven't received the rainfall recently.
And why is Oklahoma in general a good place for dual purpose wheat in this process?
Well, if you think about, let's say a lot of cows being in the eastern part of the United States. The great thing about Oklahoma, and the feed yards are in Texas Panhandle, Western Kansas, Nebraska, Oklahoma Panhandle. Well, cattle literally graze their way across Oklahoma on their way to those feed yards from the eastern part of the country, in eastern Oklahoma even. They can graze across Oklahoma in the wintertime on this green wheat forage that the rest of the country can't make cattle gain 2 to 3 pounds a day in the wintertime, but we can. And then, of course, you know, in the summertime, they can graze across Oklahoma on our Bermuda grass or native grass pastures.
And any other nutrition concerns during this process for cattle?
Well, I think the main thing there is just if they are going to come off wheat and stay at home, so to speak, so they're managed by the same person or manager, they just need to make sure that they go to some sort of a dry type safe ration, and then pretty quickly start to increase the energy content of that diet so they'll keep gaining.
Okay, thanks a lot. Some great things to think about. Dave Wallman, our beef cattle extension specialist.